Hello and welcome to the 14th part of my LEGO Powered Up tutorial that you can use for Powered Up, Control Plus and LEGO Boost. And today we won't continue with the campfire, but we will have a new part on remote controlling vehicles. And in this case, I'd like to remote control the Vanny robot from the LEGO Boost set, because I realized that we can control normal vehicles that have one motor for driving and one for steering, but we can't control tank steering or tank type vehicles that have one motor for the left side and one motor for the right side. So we will fix that today. And I looked at my collection, and the LEGO Boost robots, R2-D2 or Verney from Boost, are perfect for that, because they have one motor for the left side and one for the right side. I already created a control layout. I used two sliders, one for each motor, and we have a speedometer that shows the current speed. The two sliders have the values or the IDs 0 and 1, and the speedometer has the ID 2. So we can lock that and start with the program. We will use the sandbox that we already used for the normal vehicle control, but this time we will use two of the normal driving blocks, because we can use one for the motor on port A. Both of the included boost motors are mapped to A and B, so we can access them with the ports A and B. And we want to use the speed of the slider, or the state of the slider as speed. And that's pretty simple. That's 0 and 1. You can repeat the part about remote controlling normal vehicles if you don't understand what we've done here, because we covered everything in past parts of the tutorial. And of course, we want to show the speed, so we will need a loop for that. And the motors in the move hub have rotation sensors, so we can use their actual speed as input for the speedometer. Sometimes you have motors, maybe in the Batmobile, in the remote controlled Batmobile, that don't have included rotation sensors, and in that case you can use the slider position for the speed. But let's try it. Keep in mind that I'm controlling with a mouse, so I can control both motors at the same time, but they work. And one of my sliders has a wrong setting, because it won't return to zero. And that's a new setting for the layout designer. We can change the behavior of some blocks, so we can press on the blocks, and then we can change the color, the address. We can select return to zero, then they will return to zero if we don't press them anymore. This is helpful for vehicles, because we want them to drive only when we touch the touch screen and not when we don't touch the touch screen. But for trains, you'd normally select off, or don't select return to zero, because then they would continue to drive even if you don't touch the touch screen. And we can select instant reset. And here I forgot to enable return to zero, so we can enable that as well. So let's try something else. Maybe you want to use the remote control, and I already showed you how to steer normal vehicles with the remote control, but I didn't show you how to steer tank controlled vehicles with the remote control. And that's pretty simple as well. We can use the remote input, or the remote controller's input, instead of the sliders. But but we would have to select the port or the hub of the remote control. If the move hub is hub 1 and the remote hub 2, then you would have to select 2 for the hub of the remote control. And the remote control returns 1, 0 or minus 1, so we would have to multiply that to get proper speeds. There's one more thing to keep in mind, or you shouldn't press the red stop button of the remote control, because then the output of this block would be 127. So you would either have to think about that and find a solution, or you simply don't care and say that you shouldn't use the stop button. And there's one more idea that I want to show, because the LEGO Boost Hub has a color and distance sensor, and we could make some kind of sonar to beep when something is in front of the sensor. And that's pretty simple. It should beep faster as closer we are, and the values from the color and distance sensor range from 1 to 10. There's a block to read the actual value. It's this one. So currently there's nothing in front of it, and it will measure 10. But we want it to beep very slow or not to beep when something is far away. And there's a pretty simple solution for that, because we want it to beep so we can include a beep sound. And I think that the sixth sound of this block is a good beeping sound. So we can put that into a loop, but then it would repeat and it wouldn't care about the distance. So we have to put the distance somewhere in here. We could plug this into this block, but then we would select the sound that it plays with the value of the distance, and that wouldn't make much sense. But what we can do instead is to add a delay to wait for a given time, and we want to wait long when it has a high distance value. So if the distance is 10, and we want it to wait for a short time if the distance is low, and maybe it's 1. 10 seconds, because this block waits in seconds, is pretty much. So I would divide that by 10. Then if something is far away, it would beep once a second, and if something is close, it would beep 10 times a second. Now there is something in front of the sensor, so the value is 4, the value of the sensor, and we divide that by 10, so the output value is 0.4, and we wait 0.4 seconds between each beep. So let's try it out. It beeps pretty often, and we can drive away, and it doesn't beep as often anymore. So that works, and that's basically how we can create a beeping noise if something is in front of the robot, so that we can drive it without seeing it, because it might fall off stairs or something like that. So make sure to not let it drive too much without watching it. That was it for this part of the tutorial. Thanks for watching, see you in the next part, and bye!